In tonight's education, learn some Baltimore City parents whose children are in elementary school may have noticed an extra book in their book bag.
Yeah, but this book is different. It's a book about how to play and learn at home with your parents. 11 News education reporter Tim Tooten is live. And Tim, I did a little research on this book, and it really does look like it's great for kids and their parents.
Well, Donna, it is indeed. As you know, there's something powerful about reading early, especially for young people. That's why there's so much talk about this book. It's called The Classic Treasury of Childhood Wonders. It's written by a local author who's also a Johns Hopkins University researcher.
Take the back roads. It's much more fun, and it's really worth it.
It was story time for pre-K, kindergarten, first, and second graders at Marianne Winterling Elementary School. From a book filled with a collection of stories, songs, and games designed for children and their families.
Yeah, I mean, play in many ways is a four-letter word for our country, and in fact, it's how we learn. And so what we're trying to do is say there's great science behind play, and we learn as we play. And
okay, who do we have here? Okay, Melody.
Each one of the students will take home an autographed copy of the book, The Classic Treasury of Childhood Wonders. School officials believe it'll help to promote even more learning at home.
Folks might say, it's just a book. What's the value of this?
Well, the real value in it is the connections made between families and kids, right? The fact that families are engaging in something that's of interest to kids.
Parents say it'll also add on to what they're already doing at home.
It means a lot. It means teaching your children that you're supposed to read every day, at least twice a day and at bedtime, and then encourage them to read.
It's very important because it helps kids to read better and to tell them to read more books.
And don't be afraid to sing your own song, even if nobody likes it.
Because Johns Hopkins University and PNC Bank agreed to foot the bill for the playbooks.
So we hope that this book and its widespread distribution will cause a lot more play, but a lot more dreaming, a lot more imagination, a lot more learning that will ultimately build a wonderful and really rewarding future for all you guys.
A future the president hopes will one day land many of these students on the campus of Johns Hopkins University. Now, all of the city's pre-K through second grade students will get a copy of the book by the end of this month. Live in the 11 newsroom, Tim Tooten, WBAL-TV 11 News.